The idea behind that would be actually have a proper war, and you might be able to destroy ISIS as a, you know, as an organisation.
We've been hearing phrases, especially from the French president, about this being, quote, an act of war. I'm hearing that there has been retaliation as of this morning. Is that correct?
Well, you mean inside Syria and Iraq?
Yeah,
I mean,
yeah.
Obviously, yeah. Well, that's one of the main complaints that ISIS has about the French. To be fair and to be honest, it's not only that, and I don't think France would not have been attacked if they were not involved in the airstrikes, but certainly the fact that France is part of that campaign that is bombing around ISIS, but effectively what they're trying to do is just stop them from expanding. So their airstrikes are basically designed to try to keep them in their pen, effectively. But what they won't do is destroy ISIS itself, which is why you're hearing now a lot of politicians talking about whether or not we need to send in ground troops. The idea behind that would be actually have a proper war, and you might be able to destroy ISIS as a, you know, as an organisation.
So do you think that sending in the ground troops would be effective?
Well, it'd be effective in getting rid of ISIS as it is at the moment. There's no doubt about that. Whether or not it would be effective in making life better for everybody in the Middle East and making terrorist attacks rarer in places like France, I mean, that's not clear. Like, you might remember we went into Iraq. Part of the reason we went there is we thought that was going to help reduce terrorism. We got rid of Saddam Hussein. He was meant to be this really dangerous person. And in the wake of all that, we got something worse. You know, that can happen again. So if, you know, as bad as ISIS are, it is possible that when you bomb them and try to replace them, you end up getting something worse instead.
Do you see, or do you think, in your opinion, that, you know, obviously not the first attacks that have happened in Paris, but do you see these ones as having a possible major ripple effect similar to the attacks on New York City for September 11th?
Yeah, it's possible. I think this has really shocked the world in a way that previous attacks haven't. Even the Charlie Hebdo attacks, I don't think it shocked the world in this way, I guess, because those attacks killed 17 people. This is at least 120, possibly more. The attacks on Beirut, which, by the way, happened just the night before, and everyone seems to have forgotten all about, they don't have the same sort of effect. So I think you could see, you know, these major powers decide that this is really going to start triggering another war. And if they do that, like a proper full-scale war, and if they do that, like I say, it doesn't end easily. You know, I think one of the things we forget is it's really easy when you have a big army like us or like America to go in and destroy stuff. Mm. It's much harder to build stuff after you've destroyed it. And that was the problem that we had in Iraq. We got rid of Saddam Hussein's regime within a week. And then we were stuck there for a decade trying to fix the mess we'd made. And this is part, I mean, it's not just what we did, but this is part of the mess that was left after that. So you've got to be really, really careful about, I mean, if you're going to go in, you have to be absolutely clear about what you're going to do after you do the destroying, because that's really the hard bit.